The man who used to broadcast across Australia today had a much more personal audience. Mike Willesee farewelled at a service at St Mary's Cathedral. His close-knit family was joined by friends and fellow members of the media.
Michael Robert Willesee found religion late in life, and today that love was on display at St Mary's Cathedral, where he was given a full Catholic send-off. A giant of his craft, his funeral attracted a sea of recognisable faces, countless colleagues, each with their own stories to tell.
We all followed in his footsteps. He was the frontier leader.
I worked for him when he owned Today FM in the early days. He gave me my first proper job.
It was, of course, his family who knew him best.
You're always trying to aspire to be as good as him. Never quite made it, but did my best. But we're going to miss him.
Mike Willesee was a father of six, grandfather of 11. His son, Mike Jr., spoke of the contradiction between his father's desire for privacy and his public persona. There was never any doubt that family came first.
For a man who won Walkley's, Logie's, a Cox Plate, a New York Film Festival medal, and was bestowed the honour of an Order of Australia, it's telling the only accolade on display at home in his last few years of his life was his world's best par coffee mug.
His coffin draped in yellow roses, Mike Willesee's sons and brothers carried him from the church before saying their private goodbye to a man whose faith made him certain of his next destination.
For the majority of his life, he may not have been a living saint, but when he came to die, in typical Mike Willesee fashion, he did it well.
Jane Azzopardi, Nine News.